Thank you very much. Bahasa Indonesia, bahasa Inggris anaknya.
Campur-campur.
Terima kasih banyak atas kesempatannya. Selamat sore. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Teman-teman diaspora, teman-teman di kedutaan, terima kasih. Saya langsung aja ya. Anak-anak, should I speak in Indonesian or English?
English.
English. Okay, I will speak in English. To give you some background, we in Indonesia is trying to teach the children in Indonesia how to do programming. So you are lucky, you learn at your school, I guess, on how to program. Right now, I like to ask you questions. How many of you have built an apps for your handphone? One. Oh, okay. For your phone, handphone, smartphone, Android. Okay. So several have some experience. What kind of language you use for programming the phone?
English.
Oh, okay. Use English. Okay. that's okay, fine. So, this workshop will be divided into two sections. The first section, the first one, this one, I will show you everything. You just listen. If you like to follow, it's okay. But your main objective is to listen what I'm doing. After I do everything, then the second one, we can try to build the application ourselves. Okay? So the first one, you don't have to build. You just listen and watch the screen. Okay. What I'm going to do right now, can you read the word? It's okay? How about the one on the back? Is it okay?
Everyone can see?
Yes.
It's difficult.
Okay. Switch off the light.
No, it's okay. Oh yeah, maybe we need to switch off the light. I also make the font bigger. So what I'm going to do is, how many of you have not used Scratch for programming? Okay. Different question. How many of you have you used Scratch for programming? Oh, okay. So many of you have used Scratch. So this one is basically very similar to Scratch, but this is aimed for building apps for your phone. So it's not building application for your desktop. This is for your phone, okay? What I'm going to use is app. You can search in Google app Inventor 2. So that's the keyword, app Inventor 2. So the keyword is app Inventor 2. So this is the apps we are going to use to write the program for your smartphone. You don't need to install anything on your laptop. All you need is your browser. That's the only thing you need, a browser. So you can click this one, MIT App Inventor 2. You don't have to do it. We can do it again after this. You can watch, but if you like to do it, fine. But you don't have to now, okay? And then you need to log in to one of your Gmail account, okay? I will log in using my wife's Gmail account. So I pretend to be my wife. And then you will see something like this, okay? Now, I will create new project, test. I think test, I made test. Test number 4, too many tests. Okay, so I'll give you the basic idea. So this is the application to build another application for your phone. basically, the idea is very simple. There are two different things when you make application for your phone. First, you need to design the front end, the
interface,
the user interface. So this one is user interface design. This is the first segment, user interface design. We can put, for example, button here. You just click and drag the button. You can put whatever, text box. You can put, it can talk to Lego as well. If you want to play sound, you can click this one, media. Oops, sorry, what is media? This one, media. And you can click, choose player. You can choose whatever this one. So sound recorder, but if media, you cannot see on the screen. So media will be down here. It's a non-visible component, okay? So basically, the first segment is designing the interface. The second one, so this is the design, the designer, okay? So this is the first one, you design the interface. The second one is the actual programming. It's called block. The programming is very similar to Scratch, because all of you familiar with Scratch, it's easier for me to teach. So this is very, very similar to Scratch. Unfortunately, you are, the children in Indonesia at your age, they never learn Scratch. So you are lucky, you learn Scratch. The Indonesian, they don't know Scratch. If I ask how many of you use Scratch, no one. So you are lucky, all of you have learned Scratch. So this is the programming. What we do is something similar to Scratch. For example, I click button, this button I click. It gives choices. When button one click, do something. When button one got focus, do something. So we can drag this one. And then we click another component, for example, text box. And then we can pick one of these things. And then we can do something like Lego. Just click and drag. That's it. Very similar to Scratch, right? So it's no difference with Scratch. This, yes? What's that? Oh, okay, I will repeat. Okay. So basically, you have two different things. First, you design the interface. You see this one. Check this two menu. This one is designer. If we click designer, we move into interface design. If we click blocks, we move into the programming. That's it. That's about it. Okay? So I will repeat. First, when you do programming for your smartphone, you do two things. First, you design the interface. The second one, you do the actual programming. Design interface is this one, designer. And then we can click and drag the component. And then for programming is blocks. You can click and select the function you like and click and drag. That's it, right? Okay. After you finish do the programming, you can save the actual program. If you check your Play Store, your Android Play Store, it's called, the extension is A. What else? You know the extension of the Android program? No? Okay. The extension is APK. That's the Android program. Okay, you can see here. You can click build, and then there is option for save APK to your laptop. So you can save the APK from the internet to your laptop, and then if you want to run the APK, you can copy the APK to your phone and run it. Okay, so that's it. So I repeat again, basically you have to do the interface design and do the actual coding using blocks, and then you can save the APK to your computer. Now, the fun thing is you don't have to invent everything. Many people have uploads their application to this site. So you can steal, is it steal?
Yeah.
Well, steal is too brutal. Eh?
Take.
Yeah, you can take.
Oh, use
other people application and you can modify. To find their application, you can select gallery. There is a gallery menu here. Okay. We need to wait for a while, and then it will download other people application. You can select, you can see their source code and everything, and then you can modify. So this is some example of their gallery. Then we can there is a tutorial, feature, popular, search, and everything. Okay, you can select and then play with it. You can modify. Okay, now what I like you to do, only two things. So we will try to build two applications. The first one is very simple. The scenario is very simple. We can build application with a button. We can change the image of the button. We can put some image to the button. And then the scenario is, if we press the button, it will play a sound, whatever sound. Okay, so we can press the button, play a sound. So that's the first application. The second application, I like to put a text box, and then we can type a text in the text box, and if we play a button, say it, and then it will do text to speech. Okay, so I will do it myself first. You just watch, and then after I finish, we can do the actual workshop. Okay. So I will write another program, test 6, whatever. Okay. So I grab the button here. And then I will grab a media. So basically the scenario is very simple. We have button, press the button, and then it will play sound. The media, I will grab a player, media player here. So basically I have two, only button and media player. Scenario is very simple, press the button, play something. Okay. This button is not very interesting because this is only like this. So to make it more interesting, I will search in Google, for example, cat image. Okay, I look for cat image in Google. Which one do you like?
The second one.
This one? Okay. I will download this one. I will download the adorable cat. Wow. Oh, this is much bigger. This one is okay. Okay, save image as, I will name it cat, JPEG, save, okay. And then I need a sound. For example, I will look for a tiger or lion, tiger MP3. So when we press the button, the image is cat. The image is cat, but I need, do you know where to steal the sound from? Any suggestion, site for stealing sound? Huh? Yeah, we need to steal a real tiger sound. So people will be shocked, right? When we see a cat figure and we press it into, and the sound is tiger, so they will be surprised. We need MP3 sound for a tiger. Oh, sorry. Here, download. Oh, this one. Free Tiger sound effect. So we need to steal something from the internet. This is example. Tiger 2, 3 second. Tiger 3, 2 second, 3 second. So I will download this one. Can I download this one? Download MP3 or WAV, whatever. Okay, I will download MP3. Save. The name is Tiger 6 MP3. Okay. So I have two files. One is the JPEG file, the figure, and then one is the sound file. Okay. Now, I need to change these two. So I need to include the figure into the button and the sound into this one, player. Okay. So to do that, we need to change the property of the component. Say I want to change the button. Click the button and then we change this one. Go down here. Where is it? Image. Okay, this is none. Upload file. Browse file. Okay. Where is the tiger? Cat. Where is cat? Cat JPEG. Okay. Oh, where is it? Doesn't show up here. Too big for the screen. Yeah. I have to. How can I change it? Yeah, I have to do something. Maybe I have to do something like this. Cat. Okay. Screenshot. Okay. Select area to grab, take shot. I will steal only fraction of it. Okay. Save into cat 2. I will put it in download. Okay. Save. Okay. Where is it? Where is my, okay. I have to change again. Where is it? This one. Upload file. Browse. Where is cat 2? Cat 2, this one. Okay, open. Okay. Still too big, but we can see the cat now. Basically, it's a cat. Now, the next thing, I need to upload the audio. The tiger or lion sound, so it will fool people. Okay, select the component player, and then I will upload. Yes, upload file, browse. What's this one, right? Tiger 6. Open. Okay. Okay, so the sound will be tiger sound. So I have a button with the cat in it and the tiger sound ready. To program it is very simple. Go to the blocks. Okay, we have two component, button and player. So I grab button. You can choose whether when button one click or when button one got focus or when button one long click. You can choose whatever you want. Say I choose this one. When button one click. Right. This one. And then player. Okay. We can call player pause, call player start, call player stop, call player vibrate. Which one? Pause, start, stop, vibrate. Start. Choose start. This one. So we have two blocks. One is for the button, one is for player. So we can do like Lego, we can interconnect these two. That's it. That's our program. That's how to program an application. Now to save it is very simple. Build. Click build this one. Save to your computer. Okay. It will save to our computer. And then we can use USB cable or whatever and plug it into your phone and transfer the application to your phone. The second option is you can, this one save, right? Okay. The second option, we can click build. Okay. Oops. Okay, this one. So the name is this one. Test 6 APK, my application. Save. Okay. I will not do the demonstration because it will take time for connecting to my phone, because my phone is right now is recording me. It will be uploaded into YouTube. So there are two record. One is from the screen, one is from the phone. The second option, if you see your phone, if you check your phone, okay, check the Play Store like this. Go to Play Store, play.google.com. If you check your Play Store, you can check app Inventor in your phone. There is this one, MIT AI2 Companion. You can install this one. The purpose of this program is so you can search your Play Store and you can use keyword app Inventor. And then you can download and install MIT AI2 Companion. The purpose of this application is to connect this one. This one. Okay. You can click build. And then the previous option I choose is to save APK to my computer. The first option is provide QR code. So we can click this one, and it will provide QR code. Using the apps in our phone, we can check the QR code provided by, we have to wait 35%. Okay, come on, where's the QR code? Nah, okay. When you see the QR code using the MIT A2 Companion, we can scan the QR code and then it will redirect the phone to download the apps, and we can run the apps directly. So you don't need to use USB cable to copy to your phone. Okay? So this is the first app. The second apps. Wow. Terima kasih, Bu. Terima kasih, Bu. Wow.
Sudah sering datang, Pak.
Terima kasih. Ini sajen ya. Sajennya berat. Okay. Now the second application. The first application only button and sound. The second application is okay. I will start another. How come? Oh, okay. This one, start new project. Test 9. Okay, I will start. Okay. The second, so that's the first application. We need to have button and sound. For this one, I like you to do this one, text box. Select text box, Greg, here, okay, and then button, grab here, so we have text box and button, and then I need the media again, media, this one I will choose text to speech, sorry, here, so basically we have three component, text box, button, and text to speech. The scenario is we enter a text here, we type any text, and then here, this one we select we can choose the text here, we can type bahasa Indonesia or bahasa Inggris. Katakan Kalau bahasa Indonesia katakan ya. Kalau bahasa Inggris say it. Oke, okay, enter. Katakan. Jadi, so we can type the text here and then press katakan. And then when this one press, it will talk to text to speech and then it will show. It will give you sound. Okay. Now we do the coding. So this is the user interface. This is the designer section. And then we go to the block again to do the programming block. Click button. When button click, do something. When button click, do text to speech. We have only one purple text to speech. Click this one, and we can connect this one. So when button one click, do call text to speech speak. So what do you want to say? What do you want to say is from the text box. Okay, the text box is you, we can choose one of this. I will choose this one. Text box. This one. It's okay. Doesn't work. Oh, doesn't contain message. Okay, delete the block. Okay, again. Where is it? Available country, language, pitch. This one works. Okay, we can change the pitch if you like. So we can type anything. We type will be become a message for text to speech, and then it will speak as we press the button. So that's simple program like that. Okay. The ID is only like this. When button one click, do call text to speech, speak message, the message we type. And then we can again save or use a QR code. Before we do the actual workshop, any questions? Confused? It's okay? It's not difficult, right? Okay. I will finish recording.